Hi everyone, you know the drill. Two songs. That was Iggy Pop, The Passenger. Now we got a little bit of Talking Heads, Psycho Killer. See you soon.
to the facts. I'm tense and nervous and I can't relax. Can't sleep cause my bed's on fire. Don't touch me, I'm a real live wire. Psycho killer, qu'est-ce que c'est?
I'm eating a banana! Saskatchewan, aye, 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 aye. Who let you out of your cage?
On. It is. Good. Good! Hello, everyone in the lounge. Members or not, you're all welcome here. Duh. Good to see you all. It's Friday! The beginning of the weekend! Woo! Also, 150th anniversary of Canada is upon us! Let's begin. Choice. Out. guess what mine is tonight. Grab those 3D glasses and the popcorn and the snacks of your choice and make your way down to the seating area, where you'll be entertained for the next few hours. Prepare to laugh, cry, be scared. Oh! You are going to be scared, my children and fellow loungers. The show's about to begin. Prepare for highs and lows and sorrows. You, grab my hand. Let me take you on this magical adventure. And remember, while on it, to stay classy!
Everybody. Hey, how you doing? Ah! How come YouTube never saves volumes? Why? Anyways. This would be the smart thing to do. I should get like 2 hours of lounge music. And just have a quick play for that. So I don't have to go over to YouTube and click, you know, cocktail party mix number 97. And just get it in there. Hey, we got things coming in. Oh, the first biddy. Stay. Good. Good biddy. Okay, good. Excellent. Okay. We got things. Oh, my God. Dang it. Hold on. Remember, you kind of messed up. It's okay, Stereo. I understand. It happens. Anyways, let's get the program here. So while I was gone, Caltheon, Oxen Case, 420 Ganja, Drew Peters, Massacre, and 2 hours ago, Naked Toots came in with brand new subs. Welcome to the lounge. Thank you for those subscriptions. Love you to bitsies. Mwah. Thank you. Appreciate it. 3 months. Hold on. Whoa, that was a good one. Ancient Amber 95 coming with 3 months. Cheers to you. Give me a tink there. There you go.
Fucking hello. 6 months in a row.
To my fellow Canadians, happy Canada Day. 150 years. Now, me, I'm hoping tonight or tomorrow.
Child. You are now
a lifer. Praise be me. Goodbye.
I am hoping that tonight or tomorrow morning or somewhere tomorrow, my daughter's born and I'll have a 150th anniversary Canada baby. That'd be kind of cool. That'd be a cool day. Something to grow up knowing. I think that'd be pretty sweet. Colbe. Coming with that, Brian. Thank you so much, Cole. Thank you. Exploys. Coming in with a new sub. Thank you so much, Exploys. Welcome. Good people to the right. Scotch and drinks to the left. Enjoy yourself. There is things on tap that if you're a DD, go nuts.
Yee-wee!
Woo! Zappu coming in with that brand new Prime. Thank you so much, Zappu. Welcome to the lounge, my man. Oh, woman. It's all good, man. Highwind coming in with that brand new sub. Thank you so much, Highwind. Welcome to the lounge. Octo J, thank you for that brand new sub as well. Thank you. Blue Pack coming in with a... Hey! 50! Bucks worth of bits. A big 5,000 on the blue bit bomb. And he used the classy shaky little guy. The 5K. Look at him. Sitting in there, idle. I think my cup broke. Oh, there he goes. He's like, 5K! 5K! Jeez, Blue Pack. Thank you, man. Cheers to you, sir. Looking forward to all the drinks and laughs tonight. I don't know. Have you been watching Richard lately? There's not as many laughs as there are drinks. And killing. Well, killing's coming. Don't you worry. P.S. Do you have a mailing address? Oh, my. Well, I'd prefer a date first. We've had this discussion before in the past, Blue Pack. I should get one, but P.O. boxes are expensive. Faces here. Great. Hi. Hi, Face. P.O. boxes are expensive. We'll figure it out. Not wearing any... No. But thank you, Face. Thank you for your continued support. Always something to bring to the table. Thank you, Face. Goddamn, I love you, dude. So anyways, wow, I lost track of what the hell I was talking about. That's great. Yeah, no, P.O. boxes. No. I'll figure it out. We'll see. They're just super expensive, and people have asked me before in the past if I'm going to get one. I don't know. Well, can it justify the volume? Is that the thing we want to do here? Do we want to have, like...
Fucking A, right?
Do we want to be the stream that does stuff like that? I don't know. I'd want to share what we got. You know what I mean? But do we want to become like an unboxing thing? Like, hey, so loves to tickle himself 21 sent me this clock. Thank you, man. It's got my name and marker on the side of it. I don't know if I want to do... Oh, wrong button. I don't know if I want to do that. I don't know. What do you think? I don't know. You guys decide. We an unbox stream now. Moving up now. Hell yeah. So I got the new Elgato Stream Deck. It's good. The box, the packaging's real nice. The instructions are in color. That's important. I don't know. Do it. I'll send you a box of tiny wines from Sutter Home. Ooh, a Catalina wine mixer while we're at her. Classy roleplay is different. Unboxing YouTubers. We'll roleplay the unboxing. We'll dress up as like Thaddeus or Dimitri or Bike Man and open things up. This looks pretty good. Slight head nod. What secrets do you lie inside this box? What secrets? Hey, that could potentially be fun. Or we could pretend to be like, you know, big obnoxious YouTubers or something like that. You know, I don't know. Figure it out. I'll look into it. Gutwormy coming with that brand new sub. Thank you so much, Gutwormy. Welcome to the lounge, good sir. Thank you. Mr. Nodhead coming in with 6 months. Hi. Thank you for the glorious 6 months of entertainment, my man. Cheers. Back at you. Thank you. Thank you, my sir. For half a year. Enjoy that new badge upgrade. Thank you, pal. Now, there's a good friend of mine that we don't speak much these days. I don't know why. What happened there? Maybe conflict of interest. I don't know. Draco. 16 months. It was my 30th birthday yesterday. God damn it. Why didn't you send me your traditional Steam messages, you son of a bitch? Now I'm on the run from the collectors, but still watching PAX. Oh my God. What? Do tell. What's going on there, Draco? Shit. 16 months. Collectors are coming after you. Fuck. Never got a chance to tell you, Classmates, but congrats on your second child. I haven't had the second child yet, Finn. Not yet, buddy. We're still waiting. But hey, Finn, thanks for the sub, buddy. We said thank you earlier. I don't know if you were sticking around then, but thank you, man. Appreciate it, pal. Draco, love you to bits, dude. It's good to see you, man. Hope you're not in too much trouble. Talk to me if you are. Jesus Christ, dude. We have to catch up. Thank you, Draco. Cheeseface HD coming in with a brand new sub. Thank you, Cheeseface. Melly coming in with bits. Thank you, Melly. Reronan coming in with that prime. Thank you so much, Rero. Nan Nan. Thank you for that prime. Welcome to the lounge. Back the blue Leo wifey. Back the blue Leo wifey. Coming in with 3 months. Yay! Thank you for 3 months. Thank you, back. Much appreciated. Thank you for the continued support. Means a lot. Thank you. Cheers. KFC or KF Campbell's. KFC Campbell's? KF Campbell's? Has used 2,000 bits. Love bomb. Thank you for the 200, sorry. It's going to be one of those. I've been drinking. I've already got a head start. I've been talking with people. Getting things lined up for the future. And drinking at the same time. I'm home alone right now. I haven't seen my son for 2 days. He was first with the parents, the in-law parent. Now he's with the sister-in-law. I won't see him until probably Sunday. Yeah. So, home alone, drinking with the dog and cat. The pinnacle of... Yeah, we've reached rock bottom, ladies and gentlemen. We're there, waiting for babies drinking alone in the basement. I got all you lovely internet people. Hey, the bomb diggity coming in with that new stuff. Thank you so much, man. Welcome to the lounge. Enjoy your stay. I am. I'm going to put some more liquid in it. So, role play. What are we doing? Oh, yeah. Richard Oakes. Okay, so some things happened off stream. I was getting ready and I got a little ambitious. I should have waited until we went live so you guys could have watched it. But remember when we took that license plate from that car? Well, I went to the PD and I confirmed that it was in fact, Daniel Slater's car. So we are confirmed that that car is his. So if we see that car around town, we can trace it and we can kind of track it. Thank you, police officers, for trusting a serial killer. Everything's going according to plan. It's wonderful. So we've been playing the long game with this character, the trust game. And the methodology. Happy Canada Day for you guys showing up. Happy Canada Day. 150. So, we've been playing the trust game. So, my thought process. Let you in on my dirty little secrets. My thought process has been... Oh, classy. Oh, lewd. Hi, Hunted Spam. Hi. Has been to gain trust of the friends of them. So, Daquan, Jesse. Become good friends with them. Take them out on adventures and stuff like that. Kind of try to become the fathers they've never had. Something like that. To make Danny and Grant kind of jealous. Where they want to have that experience. And then a strike! That's the idea. So I let you out on basically what I'm trying to do. Or trying to achieve. As a character. For Richard Oakes. And we'll see if that works. If not, we'll go wherever the roleplay takes us. We have Macapone. Oakes. Oh, thank you there, Credits Moto. Thank you. Bottom of my heart. That means a lot. Thank you. Now, that's a red-breasted Wichita woodpecker. God dang it. Nathoris coming in with 2 months. Please, sir. I want some more. You're going to get more. Don't worry. It's coming. I'm going to turn off that music first and foremost. What about Granny and Reggie? What about them? I don't think they would be much help. I want to get Timmy involved, Tim Mac involved, or Macapone. just to get information and perhaps set something up with one of the two, Grant or not. I'm not too sure. It's a card in my back pocket. Timmy's not on my list. He doesn't meet the clicks and ticks that are required to offset Richard Oakes. So, I mean, he's a bitter, toughish Italian mobster guy, but that doesn't really fit within the arrogant, ignorant, cocky kid persona, look up to your elders type of thing that is required. Ouch. What ouch? What's ouch? What? What happened? What did he do? What? So that noise, was it what? What happened? What? What happened? Someone bought a t-shirt. Thank you. Who bought a t-shirt? It was a chirp? A spike or a pop? Really? You sure that's not... Oh, man. Sorry. Whatever that was. Might be a Twitch thing? Because I think I'm fine. The levels look good. The levels look great, boys and girls. Thanks again, Nathoris. Who bought a t-shirt? Who was that? You lovely individual. Oh, I didn't show you guys the store. I updated it. We're going to do a little bit of pandering right now. Not pandering, more just be kind of excited. The store is coming along nicely. That's all. Don't get excited. It's like, you know, if you're with the discount code of blah, 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 blah. But no, we updated it. It looks sexy. More shirts are coming. A wrecked emote shirt's coming right here. And eventually this logo will be, I'm thinking, a nice and small one of this, like right there on the chest, like right there, like along the side on the left. I think that looked real good. No letters, just the head. That's it. Subtle, elegant, almost feels like a real brand. Well, it is a real brand, actually, because it was made by a brand artist, like someone who does branding for companies. Did this. Talented guy. Munface was talented. And then over here. Oh, I got to show you something. Hold on. I got to show you something. Let me find it. It's finalized. Kathleen. The beautiful, lovely, and talented Kathleen.
Sent us a gift from above. Where is it?
Let me find it. Where is it? Other things.
Kathleen.
That's not it. Shoot. Hold on, I'm finding it. But the Dynasty logo's done. You guys voted on Twitter.
Yes, you did.
You voted on Twitter. We have the final version. Let me show you it. It's cool. So cool. Here it is. Lovely. So lovely. Okay, so that's the final version right there. Voila. That's the Dynasty logo with a couple background differences. You can see it. And that's the pattern. We changed the head out to the one that more people preferred. And that'll be Madam Ming's gang logo. That will be probably on a shirt as well, or a hoodie or something. I really wanted to have like gang jackets and then put that on the jacket, like purple and white. Almost like the bowling jackets, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? And then have that on the logo on the back. Like, wouldn't that be fucking cool? Like, that would be so cool. I think it would look awesome. But we'll put it on like a hoodie or something like that, like a purple hoodie. I mean, we made sure that everything was gold lined, so that way if it was on purple, it would look amazing, right? So, I mean, it kicks out. It kicks ass. Oh, by the way, the gang system, I'm working on that this weekend. If I don't have a new child this weekend, I will be working on the polishing details and systems of the gang system for the new server that is coming.
Ah, someone bought a t-shirt.
Pigstra, thanks for the purchase of a new t-shirt, my man. By the way, that is an updated version of the Know Your Role t-shirt. The other one was just a gray square. That's a limited. So if you guys have that older version with the solid background, please tweet that to me because they're no longer available. Now it's the transparent backgrounds now. So those shirts are no longer in the air. We sold about, I think, a dozen of them.
It was like a dozen or so. Those no longer exist. They're gone forever. That's the new version with the transparent background. So I'd love to see some pictures of whoever got them. That'd be cool. Blue pack, you son of a bitch! You bought the tank? Need it this summer in Oregon. Cheers. Well, thank you, Blue Pack. Jesus, man. Thank you for the total of 6,500 bits. Much appreciated. Wow. Thank you, Blue Pack. And thank you for that purchase of the shirt. Still no kid. Still no kid. No, no. We're still waiting. Yeah. I'll get you a pic of me in the new one. Yeah. Nice, man. Thank you. Please. Yeah. Tweet them to me. I love seeing them. Love seeing them. Okay. So without further ado, we've been sitting here procrastinating or just talking and chilling. Well, let's get to some role play. Let's do that thing we do here. All right. So, all right. Back to Richard Oakes.
Don't fucking move. Keep your hands up. Dispatch Sampson, I'm going to be requiring a fire department. It's going to be on Procopio Promenade just to the west of the sheriff's office. Don't move. Hands behind your back. Bad Samson. Negative. Sir, you have the right to remain silent. Anything that you say or do can and will be held against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you can't afford an attorney, one will be appointed to you by the state. You understand your rights?
I understand. Thank you.
All right, you're not under arrest. You're just being detained right now, but explain to me what the fuck we got going on, man. out here shooting up your truck or whatever. What's going on, dude?
Oh, no, not shooting up my truck. I don't own that truck, actually.
Okay. Would you like to explain to me why you're shooting this truck up?
My truck was legally parked here, and I was trying to move it and get rid of it, but couldn't quite get it out of here. And then I was trying to figure out how to refuel it properly, and well, then it got a little bit messy, and one thing led to another.
So basically, explain to me how you got into possession of this truck if it's not your truck.
That's not my truck. My truck was parked here. My truck's right down there.
Is that your truck there, the Suburban?
That's correct.
Okay, and what was going on with this truck right here?
Well, it wasn't supposed to be parked here. It looks like that person might have killed a bird right there. So I was thinking maybe a little bit.
So you thought that you would take it into your own hands and just shoot the thing up and you know, make it explode? You thought that would be a good idea because it was illegally parked?
That made it come across my mind.
So you mean to tell me that you were all pissed off because this truck was illegally parked down on the beach in a pretty open area, not really harming anybody or blocking anybody? It was just a good idea to pull your gun out and start shooting it. Is that correct?
Not necessarily, no. Not completely, a little bit.
Okay, well, explain to me so you can help me understand. So I'm trying to figure out what we have going on down here.
Oh, maybe all right. Maybe just a little too much frustration. I don't know what I got over me.
Well, sir, at this time, you are going to be placed under arrest for brandishing a firearm, illegal, legal discharge of a firearm, as well as arson. You understand that? Destruction of property?
I understand. Go to the beach. Don't go. Don't touch it.
Okay, sir, I know that you have a firearm on you, but do you have anything else on your person that's sharp that might poke me, sick me, prod me if I go and pat you down?
A couple camping utensils. I have a machete for the bushes, a hatchet for the logs, and a flashlight.
Whereabouts is the machete?
Inside coat.
All right, sir, and how about an ID? Do you have an ID or?
I do.
Driver's license.
Back left pocket.
Watch your head, sir. I'm just going to go ahead and place you in the back seat. We're going to go up to the sheriff's office and have a discussion, okay?
What about my truck?
Well, your truck is going to be impounded for the time being, sir. Gonna help go ahead and get it off of the beach for you.
That's fine, thank you.
Roger, sir. Sam 10, I'm going to be tow truck out to Propio Promenade. It's going to be.
Well, shit. Okay, so the problem is that gasoline pouring in the system here acts like multiple gunshots. It's like shooting an Uzi in game. So when you pour gas in the ground, everyone goes on fucking high alert. Unfortunately, that's what it is. So the cops, when you start pouring gas, it's like World War III is happening somewhere, and the cops go absolutely fucking nuts. So unfortunately, that's just the nature of it. I'm going to have to figure out how Rich is going to get out of this here in the next, like, 2 minutes. I think being honesty is going to be the best policy.
So, explain to me, Mr. Oaks, what was your frustration? Like, what? I'm still just trying to understand why you destroyed that truck.
No, it was a pile of many things. Illegal parking, dead animals around. It just got under my skin. I run a nature trail just actually near the logging company. And when I saw that, I don't know, what got off me? Just rough day. I mean, my old truck got hit, and then I had to go buy a new one. I just pent up anger, I suppose, and let it out in a very unjust way.
Now, Mr. Oaks, you haven't had anything to drink today, any prescription medications or drugs that inhibit your decision-making process, have you?
No, officer, I do not drink or do anything. Clean as a whistle.
They didn't find the body. As long as the tow truck driver doesn't find it, we're good. Panned, 7 months. Hey, pal. How you doing? We gotta go flying sometime. Vroom, vroom, airplanes. Fire Titan 8, $3. How do you plan on getting the killer part of the circular? It's coming, baby. It's coming. That was such bad timing. I know. Horrible timing, but it is what it is. It's those gas cans.
All right, Mr. Oaks, just give me a minute, sir, get all this typed up, okay?
Absolutely.
Your honesty and your cooperation is going to go a long way with me, and we can't be out here treating the county like the Wild Wild West, sir. I hope you understand that.
I understand. I don't know what got over me.
Killer part of a serial killer to PCs list NPCs. It's easy in a server where people hardly ever perma. Generally curious because your RP is great. I don't know. You'll be don't ever underestimate other characters in the server. People will perma. They do. It's starting to happen more. People are becoming more comfortable with the idea of perming characters. And especially in a world where NLR does not exist, it's fresh to see people perma, and it gives them a chance to try something new. So give the other role players the chance to prove that they can do that. It's awesome. And if they don't, that's fine. I'm fine with it. I'll go down. If they want to not perma and then report me and I get arrested and put to jail for life, so be it. I'll move on to the new character. It's all good, baby. It's all good. Thanks for $3, Titan. And I hope I answered your question. Coda Rince coming in with that Prime. Thank you so much, Corinth. Welcome to the lounge, my man. Oh, Wooban. Thank you. Captain in GM has resubscribed for 3 months. Thank you. Love you, Classy. Please don't kill off Rick Devine. I subbed for Rick Devine. Did you sub for Rick Devine? He'll be coming back, actually. You know what I was thinking about doing with Rick? I was thinking about making him the tour guide of the city. So whenever we bring new people into the whitelist, I probably wouldn't stream him much, but whenever someone comes to the whitelist, that first day in the server, I'm hoping I can kind of like hold their hand as Rick
Devine.
Okay,
this is what I'm going to do for you, Mr. Oaks. Again, since you were cooperative and you didn't give me a hard time or anything like that, I'm not going to hit you with the felony arson, okay? I'm consider it destruction of property.
Well, I don't mean to interrupt, but I think I should be penalized with something, either a fine or whatnot. I feel bad for what I did. I don't know what got over me.
You're being charged, sir. But I'm
okay, good.
You know,
okay, thank you.
Because you were cooperative. Because you were cooperative, I'm reducing from arson to destruction of property, okay?
Oh, well, wonderful. Okay, well, you know, the sense of where, oh, it's not going to be so hard on my account.
The total fine involved is going to be a total amount due of $2,250, and it's going to be 10 months out of the state penitentiary for the above.
How long is that again? Say that again. I didn't quite catch that.
Ten months.
10 months? Okay, that's fine. I understand that.
Okay, he's punching it in. Ronald Lovecraft coming with that Prime. Thank you so much, Ronald. Welcome to the lounge. Good set. Two bits from Nightback Gaming. Love the stream. Keep up the good work.
1091 prisoner transfer out from the Palito. £90 gonna have on.
Love the stream. Keep up the good work. Thank you so much, Nightback. Pan with 100 bits. Cheers, pal. Hey, Pan. Thanks, man. 20 bits from Double OMG.
All right, Mr. Oaks, I don't know if it was just bad decision making, but let's kind of take this as a learning lesson, sir, that we can't be, like you said, shooting up vehicles and treating the county like the Wild Wild West.
I understand. Now, when I get out of prison, where can I find my car?
Your car will be up here at the sheriff's office, sir.
Oh, up here in Palito?
It'll be here at the sheriff's office parking lot, correct?
Oh, that'd be wonderful. Thank you.
$10 months, not bad. Yeah, did he kill any players? None? NPC? I killed an NPC. Remember, NPCs and players, treat them equally. People tend to forget that sometimes. Killing someone in the game, regardless of whether or not there's a player behind it, always treat it equally. I got off real easy. Well, they didn't find the body. I like Richard, nice guy. Lucky it was Eli. Lucky it wasn't Eli is what you're trying to type. 20 bits, thank you so much, OMG. Can't wait for you to go full-time, my man. Honestly, it's going to be the best time ever. Ugh. I'm excited and terrified all at the same time. There's a Madame Ming imposter in town. I saw someone was rolling around in the same ped. That's fine, whatever. No big deal. How long am I in jail for? 9 minutes. Not bad. They didn't bother checking around the rock, so lucky me. Could have been pinned with freaking murder. That would have been... Yeah, we would have been here for the rest of the night. Well, rip stream. No, we got away with it. Yo, Richard, looks like Bill Murray. No, what are we talking about? Thanks for the entertainment. I have a 3-year-old and a 4-year-old. They grow up so fast. Enjoy it, and good luck on the latest. Thank you, Coder. Yeah, right? Looking forward to it. So, for those of you who don't know, we've actually started opening up the doors on the server a little bit. Start cracking them open, letting people in. Recommendations through the family. It's nice. Starting to see some new faces in here. My first recommendation was Hirona. You might have seen us role-playing. You should whitelist the Djibouti show. Yeah, we'll see. We were around yesterday, Hirona and I, and playing Bernie and Miriam Gold Sanderstein was kind of get the... Are you going to get B-Fly on the... What's that? Oh, yeah. Kind of rolling around with... Yeah, Burke's in here now, too, right? Does Hirona stream? Yeah, Hirona streams. Absolutely. Absolutely. Is Ringo Jesus... Probably... Ringo Jesus won't really work here. That's not really a character I should be rolling around with in Family RP. It's a little outlandish. It's a little bit. Fist the Walrus? Probably. Probably. I'll be giving him... I'll be talking to him. There's a... I got my short but sweet list.
Dude, three whole months, bud. Fucking A, right?
You saw me fall into that hole at the hospital? Yeah. You know what it takes you? It takes you to the single-player campaign mission where you rob the jewelry store and you go down those tunnels and the bank heist. It takes you there for some weird reason. I don't know why. But it does. Drew Peters, 3D. 3 months. Three whole months, bud. Fucking A, right? Love you, classy. Always still entertainment. Thank you so much, Drew Peters. Thanks for continued support. You cry when Lenny died. When Reggie slit his throat. Oh, my God. It was so good. So good. And what a way to start the fucking stream. Damn it! I was just like, yeah, we'll blow up that truck, walk away from the explosion, get in the truck and go, man. Just go. No. I gotta remember that. I keep forgetting about that. The damn fuel! The damn fuel! Because on their screen, cat alerts are like, wee, 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 when you pull that gas tank out. Okay, so what was I doing? I was not streaming. I was doing some logging, some truck logging trucks. And I was trying to fill up the truck on the side of the road, and I was trying to figure out how to pour gas in it, and I was tapping the gas button on the jerry can. And all of a sudden, cops pull up and get out, and they're like, there's shots fired in there. I'm like, no, I'm just trying to fill my truck up. Yeah, it puts the cops on high alert instantaneously. So that's, personally, I don't like that at all. The gasoline, I know you can pour it and shit, and you can set fires, but it should not make the town go nuts. It shouldn't set everyone on high alert like a freaking World War III is going off. It was bad timing, too, because where I did that, like, the police station is right up the hill. So Bucky was on patrol. Trooper gets the cat alert. It's right down by the fucking beach. I mean, the minute I started pouring gas, he was alerted. And then by the time that I got to the gunshot, he was already on his way down. So if I hesitated with the gas... A little bit longer, I could have lied my way through that, saying I was trying to fuel the truck up. Bad timing. Bad fucking timing. Slagger coming in with that new stuff. Thank you so much, Slagger. Welcome to the lounge, my man. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Bro, I want to see Bike Man as...
Tommy Jarvis. Tommy Jarvis, you crazy lady. Tommy.
Bike Man is Tommy Jarvis versus Classy as the Joker in RP. I wanted to do that so bad the other day in SOS, but Bike keeps getting off early and I keep streaming late. So we don't run into each other. So I wanted to run into him as the Joker as well. To kill the Bike Man. It would have been so much fun if we could have had that encounter, but we never got to. Oh well. Next time.
Three whole months, bud. Fucking A, right?
Next time. V-Looper coming in with 3 months. What up, man? What up, V-Looper? How you doing, buddy? Good to see you. Hope all's well. Thank you for this continued support. Enjoy the new badge upgrade. Yeah, that's a good handle, Joker. Thank you, man. Fuck me. No thanks. What's a good... That's a good rivalry right there. Tommy Jarvis and... Tommy Jarvis and the Joker. Lenny's death was brutal. Yeah, the slit to the throat was nice. And just a little bit of like a gasp of air to, and then done. Dead. Great. It was so good. Can you do a Macho Man impression? Yeah, we've done that on... I can do a Randy Savage impression. We've done it before quite a few times on stream. Ever do a Quantum Leap character? Don't know what that is. Sorry. What kind of job do you have in real life? I'm a purchaser. I work at a metal company buying stuff. Yeah, fun, right? Not fuck me, but fuck me. Okay. Classy, loved your Joker in SOS that one night. Thank you, man. Glad you liked it. Selenia confirmed dead? Yeah, Lenny's dead. Dead. Not coming back. Done. I thought about putting him in a coma or something like that, but then we didn't get the EMT involved. We didn't do any of that. We just sat there looking at his corpse and played Sir McLaughlin. So I was like, fuck it. I mean, if we role played out the hospital and got the EMS involved, hell yeah. Hell yeah, we could have, but nah, it'd be pretty cheap of me to bring him back after that, so he's done. Fucking Colgate. Charlene, you're done. You're dead. Please do a Freddie Price impression. We've done that so many times. My God. So who's drinking tonight? I am. We got work to do tonight, by the way. Who do we have? Okay, so Grant's on. Check. Is 5-0 Antho's on. He's a good cop. He's a real life cop. There's a lot of cops on tonight. Boscarelli, of course, Bucky, Shorty's on. I don't see Gilly. So if we're going to go after anyone, it's going to be target number one, Grant. Target number one. Daquan, what's his character's name? Is he online? I don't know. I don't know what his name is. I always forget. Smoking a joint, does that count? Sure. Gilly got off a bit ago? Okay. I know Pinkleton's doing a 24-hour. Can I do Christopher Walken? Eh, you know, kind of. It's okay. It's not a 10 out of 10. It's a solid 8 on the scale of Walkens. Hi-yo. Cowbell. You planning on playing more with Danny guy from yesterday? That Danny guy? What Danny guy from yesterday? I'm a little confused. Mr. Moon barely streams. That's why we need our Freddie Price fricks. Oh, am I your... Oh, yeah. No. We're not going to do that, okay? Moon's taking a break. He's doing editing. He's busy. But I'm not going to be your Moonstitute, your Moon substitute. All right? I got too much respect for the man. I can't be doing that all the time. I don't think he likes it. A teeny ribbit, $5. What's the process to get into the family? You gotta be a good role player. Know the culture that's required here. The people that I'm recommending anyways, I'm being very picky. People that I know that can adapt to a community and are gonna be very selfless about the process. As for people who want to get into the family, improve themselves down the road eventually. Yeah, we're free now. Cool. Down the road eventually, we're going to have a public server. That's going to happen. When? I don't know. A month? Something like that. And then that's where cops, myself, will be on there role-playing, interacting with people. We're going to mingle in the public server, go to the wireless server, go to both. Counts me out. I'm totally selfish. Yes, you fucking are, Melia. You'll never make it in here. Not in a million years. It's always me. What about Melly? I've seen your Twitter. Nothing but fancy backgrounds and like sunsets with some type of inspirational quote on it. Followed by a dangling carrot quote like, I'm, nobody loves me. And then everyone below, like, we love you. And you're like sitting there going, yes, it worked. And now you work, Melly. Madam Mingle? Who the hell's that? Kuma pause. True, I'm just wondering where you start. How you get noticed? It won't be hard if you're a role player. A lot of us keep a... I personally play in a lot of servers. Believe it or not, I do play the video game and I do go into role play servers without streaming a lot. Yeah, no. Big surprise there. I think everyone knows that I play the game a lot without streaming. Those are my, you know, when I get the free time when I'm either, you know, watching the baby, for example. If I got the baby monitor, I don't like streaming with the baby monitor because you never know when I'm going to leave. What am I drinking? Lafroy Quarter Cask. And I'll find myself on Revel. I'll find myself on True Los Santos RP. Variable 7. RP first. And I will go to those servers and I'll play random characters and I'll run around. And I like it because if I have my name changed and stuff like that and put on a persona, try a different character that no one really knows and go in there, you'll be surprised how different people talk to you. I'm not trying to like pedestal here, but there is a percentage of people that will read your name and act differently around you because you're just because you're a certain individual. It just it happens. I'm not trying to toot my own horn here. It's just if you're someone else and you're kind of hiding away from it and going into the role play, you'll be amazed how much more, especially in public servers, how much more organic it can get, and they'll treat you the way they would treat someone else, and it's nice. And you can really find the diamonds in the rough there. Like, there's some people in public servers that have shocked me. And I'm like, who the hell is this person? I gotta find out who it is. And that's the hard part, is sometimes, you know, figuring out if they have a Twitter and shit like that without trying to, like, break out of character. Yeah. But I've been making my list, and I've been very picky about it. And I'm going to be recommending, I think, a total of 4 people. And that's it for, like, quite a while. And this is initial because we're trying to also balance things when it comes to... Because right now, like, I think it's a pretty unanimous thing that this is the culture's here. The rhythm's here. But everyone knows underlying that this is just, like, this is only temporary, this place. And I hope, you know, a lot of people understand it too, of where they're not too worried. Like, you'll grind the money and stuff like that and do your thing. Absolutely, you should. And not worry about it. Even if you lose it, too bad, boo-hoo. But everyone knows that eventually the server that we are wanting, the dream server, is coming up. And it should be amazing. Absolutely amazing. Any servers to recommend? Stop looking because of getting RDM'd out of the gate. Whitelist, obviously. You want to eliminate or alleviate or drastically decrease the amount of garbage you encounter? Whitelist. Take the time to do whitelist. It'd be amazing how many fuckboys don't even bother reading a whitelist form and filling it out because they're lazy and they're fuckboys and they don't care. Whitelist takes out a good 70% of the riffraff. The other 30% think they're hot shit, get in there, and eventually they'll get the boot because they're just so high on themselves. this is a very pessimistic conversation I'm having right now. I'm sorry. I'm being a little brutal. But but if you do care, and if you want a place to play, go to whitelist servers. True Los Santos RP. If you want some heavy serious stuff, that's a heavy server. If you want something in that in-between area, they got 2 publics and a whitelist. Revolution Gaming. They have a server. A good friend of mine, Mr. Taugs, is one of the cops slash. I think he's head admin there. One of the head admins. Good server. Good people. TeamSpeak integration. Wonderful place. Absolutely wonderful place. I do recommend you check it out. Variable 7 is a public one that I don't actually mind too much. And RP First is another option as well. RP First, it's okay. I don't mind it. I don't mind it. Classic. But it's a little lighter. I haven't found a good whitelist yet, but I'll keep looking. Okay, all right, Flex Saga. I do recommend the Revolution or True Los Santos, definitely, if you're looking to get somewhere right now, because we don't have whitelist open right yet, unfortunately, for public. Chaz FPS coming in with that brand new Prime. Thank you, Chaz. Welcome to the lounge, good sir. Ever tried STRP? What is STRP? I don't know what that is. Maybe I should call a taxi. Get a ride from the prison. There are no vids of Gordy on the family RP. No, Gordy has not come back yet from Canada. He's still in Canada. So he hasn't been on the family. Gordy was retired in SOE. He will come back. When? I don't know. When it feels right, I guess. Oh, I think my wife's home. I can hear the rumbling upstairs. And she's home with someone else because the dog's super excited. Hi.
Hi.
Furniture? Yeah. What'd you do? You bought a couch? Yeah. You go up to the city, like, and you come back with a couch?
Couch, a dresser, and a...
I'm streaming! Okay. Well, you're pregnant, so I forgive you. All right, hold on. I'll be right back. Better be comfy.
It's a...
Yo, did you call for a taxi, man? Hello? Hey, Daydreamer. Snap, snap. Wake up, man. Hello? All right, suit yourself.
Oh God, please nobody be there. Please nobody be there. No. What happened? No! Bad timing! Bad timing! My wife, my overly pregnant wife came back with a couch! Did I miss a taxi? Did I miss a taxi? No!
Classy.
God damn it! Fuck!
Walked up to the counter, laid down the greens, and said, "Thank you, Sam."
Son of a bitch! Fuck! I'm gonna call another one. Well, I'll let you all know, it wasn't a couch. It was pieces of a couch. Upon piece upon piece. Yeah! God dang it. Anyways. Blinko, 1,000 bits. Hi! How are you? God dang it. Thank you, Belinka, for the 1,000 bits. Nibbles coming in with a brand new Prime. It's an IKEA couch to boot. So it's like nothing to even brag about. It's not like, you know, the new Eau de Lore line from Francesca or, I don't know, you know, upper couch lingo. It's literally hashed out Swedish couch. Like, that timing couldn't have been fucking worse. Eli's here. Hey, champ. Love all my people in the chat. How you doing, Eli? Good to see you, man. How's things? Coming in with $50. Dude. Hey, Eli, what are your thoughts on this? Before I read your message here, thank you, by the way. But what are your thoughts on this? Gasoline pouring. When you pour the gas and the cops go fucking nuts, like it gives up cat alerts, like it's gunshots. Should that be removed? I think it should be removed. That's just me. When someone pours gas somewhere, that's not World War III. I'm just saying, I get concerned. But, like, you know,
AK-47, and then the cops rain down. I'm not a big fan of it. I'm just gonna say it right now. As a civilian, not a big fan. If the cops want it, I get it. I get it. If the cops want it, sure, whatever. But RPG incoming mortar fire. Like, I mean, that's literally what's happening when you pour that gas. Okay, so Sheriff Eli comes in with 50 bucks. Couldn't tip last time I was by, so I figured I'd drop by and show some love. Thanks for being awesome, coach, teammate, role model, buddy. Best in the business by far. You are the man, bud, and I am truly lucky to have met you. Happy Friday. Fuck you. Don't make me emotional. I'm a grown-ass man. Eli, thank you for the 50 bucks. Most importantly, thank you for the kind words. Yeah, man, thank you. Goddamn, I'm gonna get rid of this webcam. So, yeah, thanks, man. This is my new character. Serial killer. Hi. Hasn't killed anybody yet. Been pretty good with staying out of trouble for the most part. I've been working real hard on making a good evil character. A very good day. We're playing the long game. We're playing hardball. I killed NPC. That's the thing. Why do you laugh at that? Don't laugh at that. Treat players and NPCs equally. Do that. At least try to. I understand it's hard to get attached to the guy running around, you know, there's a snake in my boot. Someone poisoned the watering hole. I get it. It's hard to take them seriously. But that's what makes this place good, is that you can go to jail for murder for killing an NPC. You have to. Otherwise, you just might as well throw all the rules out the window. Seriously. God dang it. Hey, but here, but you have to agree. For those who were here at the beginning of the stream, do we have a clip of that shit? So at the beginning of the stream, I'm going to call that Tex one more time. He's probably like, he's just AFK again. So at the beginning of the stream, we start off, we do this lovely pan to a corpse below me of where I have hatcheted it on the beach. Fuck yeah. Rolling out hard. We go around, we go to his parked car where he hit a dead seagull. It was beautiful. All the triggers were there for the character. It made sense. Everything was lined up, rolling with the punches. Then I start pouring my AK-47 RPG fire juice all over the car to erase the evidence of the truck, or at least burn it and whatever. And, of course, Bucky is at Polito Bay's sheriff office, and he hears in the distance rockets and Apache helicopters coming in, a.k.a. petrol being poured, and comes down there just as I'm done pouring the petrol and firing my gun at the truck. The truck explodes wonderfully as my hands are in the air being arrested. He tells me not to move, but I kind of move a little bit because the fire is literally coming down to my feet and I'm about to be set on fire by my own damn fire that I made. So I move a little bit. And and then, this is the best part about it, though, is that Bucky didn't search the whole area. He never found, he didn't, one rock, like, the size of a bus. If he were to walk around it, just 30 degrees, he would have seen the corpse of the person. We got 10 minutes and $2,000. So, if anything, a botched intro, thanks to mortar fire gasoline. We got so fucking lucky because Bucky didn't check around that block. You know why? You know why? Because this guy is a fucking turtle. He's a boring ass person. If you watch this person from anyone else's stream, he's white bread. He's this old, weird, over polite guy. And that's the fucking secret. That's the secret. It's not like, oh, hello, boys and girls. Oh, I forgot. Where'd my kids at? Let's go to bingo run. We don't do that on tomorrow. People be like, what's up with him?
But if it's a guy that walks around all nonchalant and just asking, you're like, I just want him to see if you could run me and do me a big favor. So this is what happened yesterday. Let me do this something again. Example of how this works. This is how this works. So earlier today, before I started streaming, I went to the police station. And I literally had wrote down Danny Slater's license plate from his car. I didn't know whose car it was. I wanted to find out if it was Danny's or it was Grant's. I went to the comp station. I did a 311. I told the story about the rear ending of my truck. I wanted to confirm. I didn't want to press charges. I just wanted to talk to the young man to say that, you know, I am sorry. I hope that, you know, that I don't appreciate stuff like that. And I hope you learn from it. Teach him like a lesson as a younger child. The cop fluently ran his license plate, gave me his name so I confirmed which vehicles his. I was able to get all that information because I came in there nonchalant and boring and not like, what's this guy up to? Obviously, if you watch it from my end, it's a little different. I mean, we add the sound and shit, but recognizes the face. But yeah, that's this guy's, that's this guy's fucking plan. To other people, he's this goddamn boring guy with binoculars talking about birds and bees and shit. And like, you know, moss grows on the north side of the tree. But damn it, we are going to whittle people apart. Whittle them apart. I got my list. I got my damn list. You're going down, Grant. You're going down, Danny. And we're going to just, we're just going to like cut in. And the best part about it is that we're not going to cut directly at them. We're not going to go after Grant. We're not going to go after Danny.
Fucking A, right?
Sarapocalypse. Oh, lovely Sarapocalypse. How are you doing, my girl? Missed the taxi. Feels bad, man. I'm sorry. I know I'm horrible. I'm going to call again. Because I do. It's not this guy. Let me break some more stuff down for you here about the methodology, what we're going for here. I'm going to give you the plan because I don't care. It's all part of the fun of it. You're along with the ride, so join me. Stony Habit, 2 months. Thank you so much, Stony Habit. Nettle coming in with 3 months. My glass isn't empty now. That's right. Upgrade. Lap it up. There's liquid in there. Enjoy it. Finwizzle coming in with that brand new sub. Thank you so much, Finwizzle. Welcome to the lounge. Drinks to the left. Good people to the right. Enjoy your stay. Thank you. So, for the love of God, new message. What do you mean, new message? Jesus. Phone. Messages. Yes. Yes, please. All right, we got it. Sorry, I missed it. Anyways, okay. Anyways, so this is the plan. Danny, we did the nature walk with him. We all know this. We went with Danny, Grant, Daquan, and Jesse. What we gathered from that trip for triggers toward him is that Grant and Danny are disrespectful, selfie, greasy, loudmouth, obnoxious teenagers with no respect for elders. Jesse was nice, and Daquan was rational. He sweared, but he was rational. What do we do? Well, if we just go directly toward Grant and Grant and Danny Slater, it's not going to work. It's not going to work. They were scared of me as it is when we were going on that trip. And if I just like, hey, you want to hang out and get coffee? They'd be like, no, fuck you. How do you get to them? How do you earn their trust? Earn their friends' trusts. Become friends with Daquan. Become friends with Jesse. I've already hanged out with Daquan already by himself. By himself. And what the end goal is to make them jealous because they're hanging out with me. I want to be able to get Jesse and Daquan to hang out and Grant and Danny being like, what the fuck? And they want to get on it. And then I'll bring them in individually and BAM! Got him! That's the goal. Now, Sarapocalypse is here, so shit. Now she knows. Whatever. But, you know, if we're good role players here, we're gonna roll with the punches. But that's the idea. That's the idea. Is we're trying to basically lure them from an angle. Not directly. Because directly with this type of stuff doesn't work. They're already nervous about him. You gotta gain that trust. And it's gonna take time, but we're gonna do it, damn it. And it's gonna be sweet. Sorry, late.
Boom. You're thinking too hard. No, I'm not thinking enough. It can go deeper. If you think about it, that's actually pretty... It's a pretty basic plan. It's not even that complex. You can go much farther, but the thing about it is you got to kind of crunch, or at least I do. I have to kind of compress time because I don't have... I can't do eight-hour streams. I can't dedicate 6 hours to stalking someone. I fucking would. If I could, I would. I would be up on that hill with binoculars, watching down here for a solid 2 hours of people, like, running around the parking lot, picking up my friends! I would be down up there just watching the whole thing, keeping track of what they do, how they move, how they act, what cars they have. If I had that time, I would totally fucking do that. But we don't have that time. So we gotta compress these systems, compress these ideas. So we gotta cut hard, but at an angle. You can't go direct, you gotta go from an angle. And that's the friend zone system I'm trying to get to. Obviously, I'm not their age. I'm not gonna be walking around in bright yellow pants and, you know, what up, dude? I'm gonna have to, like, approach it from, like, a father figure, take him fishing type of thing. But damn it, I'm hoping it works. I'm hoping it's successful. That's the goal. And for backstory-wise, we don't know what his count is. All we know is he has that really sad backstory that we did the other day. For you guys remember that? I mean, it was, you know... what was it? It was, walking around, and he was at the playground, looks at the playground pieces, brings up the memories.
Well, way to go, you little shit. What? Am I supposed to feel sorry for you? You're the reason your mother died. Do the world a favor and jump off the top next time, then I won't have to keep spending my money on feeding your useless little ass. You can walk home for all I care.
So we did that the other day. So we've done a little bit of build up with him. I'm planning on trying to release more information about him, obviously, so you can get a little more depth to him. But we're gonna do that in slices. So it's a little bit of now time, a little bit of prologue, a little bit of now time, a little bit of prologue. That is the idea. Fun character. Now, obviously, he's a bit dark. I get that. We're not used to that here. We're used to goofy characters, let's be honest. Like, we're used to Classy Packs doing funny characters. This is not a really funny character, except for every now and then with the Mr. Dick and Backdoor Adventures and stuff like that. But, all in all, pretty fucking dark. Don't worry. After this character, we'll take a break from dark. And we will go. And I'm good. Thank you. Love you. Thank you. Woo, we got food. Lovely wife came up with food. I don't see Bill Murray. I see an older... Oh, God. True fight. My God. But, yeah, don't worry. We'll be probably doing a little bit of Bernie Gold Sanderstein. And, potentially that hobo idea. I kind of want to bring back another hobo. I don't know why I liked it. Gordy's so dark. I'm not bringing dark Gordy. Nah, that doesn't make any sense.
I'm the terror that flaps in the night, bud. Oh, you're gonna get fucking poked by a knife, eh?
That's just not gonna work at all. Where's my cab? Taxi ain't coming. More hobos? Yeah, why not, Eli? Come on, hey. Come on, Eli! What would you rather be doing? Getting in high speed 9 chases 10 times a fucking day, bank robber heist? or pulling over a drunk hobo and getting entertained for 2 minutes. Come on, be realistic here. Because then at least you can sit back, Hobo Henry. It's Harry.
And you already recognize.
You forgot his name? Eli. My God. Shame. Hobo Henry. No, it's Harry, and he died. What? I remember getting pulled over, getting flashlights in my face, stumbling around. Oh, it was so much fun. I missed that shit. That was good. Problem is that he got too big. That was the issue. The problem is that people kept giving him money, like copious amounts of money. It was here. One of the old cops who actually got fired like a month later. It was right there, like chasing one of my characters down, tackled me to the ground and like gave me $20,000. It made no fucking sense, but it happened. I've had other cops like give me like $10,000. It's just insane for a hobo. Brandon Carr tried to get me on the right track. By the end of it all, I had like a hydraulic El Camino, a wife, two houses. I had more money than most civilians had jobs. And I didn't work. I did. Okay. Fun fact. The whole time I was Hobo Harry, I did one job. Like one, go and get a truck, drive around, do a job. The rest of it was on the spot and made up fucking shit. Like fake tours, begging for money. And I had stupid amounts of it's like stupid amounts of money. And Carr gave me like 50,000 fucking bucks for a house. And I sold the house for booze. I remember when I sold that house. Fucking bought like stupid amounts of liquor and just got fucking piled. And then the thing was is that it was this vicious fucking circle of me putting on like this big show of like, you know, just how would it go? Oh, no, not that song. That's hold on. Where is it? Let me find it. I still got my hobo soundtrack. Yeah. Hobo soundtrack. It was like, is this like come up to someone just be like, hey man, what's going on? Hey, you think you can spare them weary old soul? Maybe $10, give me a Tuesday, man. Just gotta get to Tuesday, just get a nice chicken soup and a warm blanket. And they would this wrap around my fucking figure. I would make them a laugh. And then the minute they walk away, it was like, oh no, no, it was like, what? It's a liquor store. Every fucking time. Every fucking time. Just never learned a lesson, but then we did go straight. We did go straight. Eli got me on the right path. I didn't do crime anymore. I stopped doing all bad crime, got married, and then killed a rival hobo and died. Fun story. Hobo was great. So much fun. Hi! There's a cab supposed to be here. Cab's not here yet. Where's my cab? Too young. I miss Gassy too. She was great. I loved role playing with Gassy. She was so into the server, like just in the world. It was great. Casper Friendly coming in 2 months. Thank you, Casper Friendly, for continued support. Love you. Thank you. Charger Hellcat Dallas coming in with that new sub. Thank you so much, man. Welcome to the lounge. One bit from Springer. A whole fucking penny. Here's a bit of for old Harry. Wonderful. Now that I read that, that's great. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Springer. That's really good. 100 bits from RRMP. Rip Hobo Harry and the four breezes. The four winds! The four winds. The four breezes. God damn it. Now you're just fucking bugging me. Hobo Henry and the four breezes. God damn it. You guys are horrible.
What was the Star Wars movie? Return of the Lemmy? Return of the Semi? What was that movie called?
Jedi!
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's what it was. That was a good movie.
Apparently not. You don't remember.
I remember. It had that, it had that J.C. Slater.
Darth Vader!
Yeah, that's it. The dark guy.
Yeah, too soon. Classy makes a new character and people fall in love and then hit him. Yeah, Pentahearth summed up my stream perfectly. I'm Game of Thrones on fucking Twitch. I show you a new character, make a new house, y'all fall in love with him, and then BAM! I fucking kill him. Too bad. I'm Game of Thrones. That's what Pentahearth said. He's just like, it's like, classy dude, I make a new character and I get all excited to meet him, and then you just go and fucking kill him like goddamn Game of Thrones. Pentahearth was just cracking my ass up. It was so good. He was so happy but so pissed. So mad. You could see it because he was laughing about it because he brought in that new character. You've all seen actually, he just permed that character. Bershonda. You guys know what I'm talking, right? About Bershonda. Lovely lady. A bit evangelical. And definitely has a vitamin S problem. But he was so excited because Francis Sinclair and Bershonda had like almost the same weird cultural twisted reality. And then I go and fuck a perma the same day I meet him. And he was just like, I found my true RP companion with like this character. He goes and fucking kills him. Grip My Wings. We gotta watch this. Is this a Bershonda clip? Yes. Absolutely, yes. We are watching this. Oh, this is gonna be good. This is gonna be good. I can already tell. Pentahearth's got his big shit-eating grin on. Whenever he smiles like that, you know something's gonna be just savage as fuck. That's just Pentahearth style. Here we go.
West Eclipse in West Vinewood. Ms. Lawson is really not necessary, ma'am. No. You don't have to prove to them that you can fly, ma'am. Come on back down here, okay?
Just,
it's really not safe.
Just
believe, brother.
Guys.
Believe, brother.
Look at it. Look at that grin. Look at that grin. You know what he's doing.
Ms. Lawson, come on now.
It's okay, brother.
All right, you guys.
It's okay.
I don't get a quote across the street.
He's gonna kill himself, I think.
It's not okay, ma'am. Just don't be jumping off anything, okay?
Lord, please, grant my wings as I know that you will. Give me the gift so I may prove to these non-believers.
Ms. Lawson.
Look at this face. He is so fucking excited. He's got half chub. Ready to slay. You gotta appreciate him for, like, just, he's got such a great twisted humor. Look at this.
Please, Lord. I can't wait to fucking kill my character.
Dude,
it's
just,
okay.
Dude, just wait, man. Let's talk.
I can't. Hold on, I can't look. All right.
This. Now, hang on now.
Lord, please,
now,
guide my wings through the 3,000-year war
Lawson,
of holy retribution.
Anything, man. Ms. Lawson, no! Ms. Lawson!
Oh, my God!
Was that Jesse?
Ms. Lawson is
Was that fucking Jesse? That could have been timed better. Just turn around and fucking starts like gagging. Oh my God, what the hell is he even doing here? Why is he in a jumper? Was Pentahearth like hitting on his character or some shit? Oh my God, that's gold. Fuck, I love Pentahearth. He's one of the... You know what makes Pentahearth great? There's a reason why they call him the Bushmaster. But man, Pentahearth, like, he goes right down to the core of it. He does. Like, he plays characters true. It's impressive. Pentahearth goes right into the meat and potatoes. Bershonda was having a church service that let us Was he going for a whole, like, a tequila love? Really? Was he going for the punch thing? Like, you know, spiking the punch, let's all drink together in our snuggies and sing off and go to the ever-flying mothership type of thing? Was that the idea? Jack Jackson. I love Jack Jackson. The closest to perfection of a criminal. Him and Omar. Omar and Jack Jackson. That's me. I'm going to say it. The closest thing to feeling like you're actually in front of a criminal, like a real criminal. They're close. They're really fucking close. And I'm not talking like movie criminal. I'm talking like I met this guy behind a gas station once and he was shady as fuck. That's Jack Jackson. Like, if you ever went into like a crappy part of town, buying like a restaurant or something like that, and you see some guys hanging out smoking cigarettes, looking at vehicles funny, that's Jack Jackson. Like, he pulls that shit. Legit. It's so cool. Love it. Penta Earth is... I think Penta said he's... isn't gonna do Jack anymore? Why not? Jack was awesome. He was on today. He was doing, I think he's kind of making fun of the parking lot. We call it the circus here. But I think he was sitting there being that toll booth guy at the parking lot, which is a brilliant fucking idea, by the way. Being the owner of the parking lot and then charging people to come in there and park. From a Pender standpoint, that's fucking genius. That is fucking genius. Take advantage of that flying circus. Such a good idea. People going in and out of that parking lot. Yep, $10. I hope that slows down the traffic there. That's a brilliant idea on Pentair's part. Yes, it's $100 a day. Yes! My man, Pentair. He's got to get a license for that. He has to. Because people have to quit hanging around that parking lot. I love everybody who's here. I love them as individuals and role players. But seriously, get out of that parking lot, get in the world, and play your character. Quit loitering around that damn parking lot. Good job, Pentair. Keep that shit moving. That's actually a brilliant idea. He's going to be rich, too. That first couple of like hours, he's going to be lucratively rich. Already cleared by Eli? Really? Did you already do that? Nice! Yes! Victory! Cheers, everybody! The circus is over! Yeah! No more circus, and Pentahearth is gonna have a fuck ton of money. Shit. So good. We did it, Reddit. We did it. Where the hell's my cab? Damn it. Nobody want to pick up the serial killer? Come on. I got a tinted van and candy. Let's go. I'm excited. Can you really act like you're an RP? Hell yeah. What are you talking about? Just play the role. I mean, duh. We obviously do this stuff to, you know, when it comes to stuff like this, we play games to escape reality so that we can do things like pretend we're serial killers or police officers or firefighters and medics and supervillains and whatnot. We do this stuff to escape reality, to do things we cannot do in real life. But at the same time, what makes this place so great is that you can get so emotionally involved in it because it feels real. It feels plausible. The minute you see a guy running around with a wolf mask on or a full monkey suit or an alien costume or an animal talking to you, and I'm not talking the Bond thing with the police thing, I'm talking like just someone role-playing a fucking seagull or running around with a rocket launcher, that emotional and connection disappears in an instant. You are disconnected, like, that second. Because you're like, that's not right. Where there's moments of like, Pentearth can detest this, Eli can detest this, of where you're sitting there, and it may seem boring, maybe for a viewer sometime, but you're sitting there on the side of the road, like right now, I'm just sitting here waiting for a taxi. Because that's something someone would do. And it may seem mundane and boring to you, but to me, it feels good. Now, we could go run off somewhere and jump and hippity-hop over to the next station and steal a car, but it doesn't fit this character. That's not something this guy would do. It's not his style. It's not his MO. And those situations of where you're, like, we're hunting someone, we're gathering information, that shit's intense. So intense. Love that shit. I fucking hate the jump and run. Oh, it's brutal. I get it. In one hand, I get it. Because it's like keeping your fingers busy. I get this. I mean, some people do it because they're just killing time. And they're talking to chat. They're doing that shit. Sprint jump all the way to... no thanks. I get it. People do it, and I can tolerate it. But I'm telling you, if you want to blend in the world, I can sit by the pillbox sometime and just watch the people walk by. You can tell a player from a mile of fucking way because he's like... He's doing the 100-meter hurdle, jumping every 6 seconds. It's just... Yeah. It's out of my control. It's not something you make a rule of, but... I wish less people did it, personally. And it helps. It helps immersion tenfold. It really does.
Mm-mm.
You can't disable it, Drew. You know why? Because it's the same mechanic as hurdling, like over obstacles. You can't, unfortunately. Although I wouldn't mind stamina being fucking drained. Like if they could. You know how you got light jog, right? This makes sense. Light jog, the dash, that'll make you run out of stamina. Imagine if you just did like this once and you ran out of stamina. Once or twice. Like once, twice. Do that in real life. Tell me how quick you get tired. You get tired real fucking quick jumping around. You gotta be in damn good shape. Your stamina should just like gone. Gone. If you can't make them, force them. Just boom, like out of breath. It's like, how come I can't run? Well, because you're jumping while you're running. Slaughter coming in. It's a bird. Slaughter Co., 14 months. Sprint and jump. The Slaughter. Dude, I can't wait till you stream. It's going to be so good. Oh, by the way, if you're around this weekend, it's a bird. My kid doesn't pop out. We're going to go through the criminal system. We're going to get that polished, finalized. Timothy's going to be around this weekend. Timothy Dexter, I hope you're around. We'll get that crime system polished and smooth, and then we'll present it to the admins. Be sweet. Sorry, guys. I'm also eating. My wife went and got me a burger for my lovely couch labor. Okay, now I'm starting to think... Unless I'm holding for a full up reel, I'm really hoping for it's going to be a Canada Day thing. Too late. Oh, too late. Oh, shit. All right. We could do a tweet.
Oh, 3-hole mod spot. Fucking A, right?
All right, here we go. Let's get that rolling. Baron coming in with 3 months. Hey, man. Thank you for that 3 months. Well, enjoy that new badge upgrade. Candy Moist. My girl, DJ, coming in to save the day. Now, what would Richard think of Candy? Probably not too much. You have that suit and wear it? Where's,
the dog.
That clip.
And he already recognizes the face.
What do we got here, man?
Oh, this is a security guard?
I gotta check this out. More Pennyworth. Love it. This is the guard I saw.
Oh, it means a lot, man. This is like, dude, like, Classy really is like... Classy's gold tier RP, you know what I mean? Like,
oh, come on,
he is the standard, you know? And dude, it's not even me trying to fucking suck his dick. Just cause he tickled. Just cause he tickled my balls. Like, it's really not. You know what I mean? Like, Classy really is the fucking golden fucking seal for RP, duties.
Cool. Thanks, buddy. I'm honored. I don't know what to say. thanks, buddy. Thanks, Penrith. Thank you, dude. Appreciate it, man. King of Beans, 2 months. I love you. Good timing on that one. You and Pentaherth both. Thank you, King of Beans. Thanks for that 2 months. Teo TV coming with 1,000 biddies. Thank you, Teo. Thank you for that support. I'm gonna put that directly toward booze or diapers. I haven't decided yet. Shit going in or shit coming out? No. We'll figure it out. Thank you, Teo. Means a lot. Lenny would have appreciated that more than you. Yeah. Where's the cap? Candy Moist is coming to pick me up. Classic. Now, here's the question. Here's the question. Is she going to come down there? Or is she going to come down that ramp right there?
I'm here to pick up a guy, Candy.
I can see it. That's Candy style. Burke on family. Yeah, Burke's in the family now. By the way, Slaughter Co. was planning this because he was watching Burke back play. What do you guys think about this? Actually role-playing like a Tuesday night bingo. There is enough seniors in the game. I shit you not. Burke Black plays an old guy. I play Bernie. Hirona plays Miriam. Pentaherth's character is old. What if we actually like set up an actual like sit down and play fucking bingo in the game? Slaughter Co. would be on the PA.
You'd be like calling for a B2. B2. Next. We got a I-7. I-7. 7 times. Just the amount of times my wife tried to divorce me. Now we got a N-14.
N-14. Like, that would be just so fucking epic. It would be so good. Like, just the driest shit. And a bunch of old people sitting in there. And just like, bingo. It would just be the funniest fucking shit ever. You can only do it once or twice. You can only do it once or twice. But it would be gold. It would be gold. It would be just as good, if not better, than the cash cab. Where'd that car come from? Here we go. Hello? Are you the lady that I sent the tweeter out? The twit? Hello?
I'm sorry. Yes, sir. Was it you that needed the ride?
That was me. Thank you so much, dearie. I've been trying to get a hold of the taxi cab service, and they just seem to be ignoring me.
Yeah, the taxis are pretty horrible in this city. What were you in for?
Oh, no, I wasn't in, dearie. Sorry, no, I was actually visiting my grandchild.
Oh, well, what's he in for, if you don't mind me asking?
Oh, we got a little trouble with the law, a little bit of drinking and driving.
Well, hopefully they can rehabilitate him in there.
I agree. You don't mind if you give me a ride up to Polito, do you? Polito Sheriff Department, if you don't mind. I plan on picking up my son.
You gonna go, Sheriff, with the van? All right, Eli, take her easy, pal. Later on, dude. Take her easy, man.
So I'm Candy. What's your name?
Oh, my name is Dick. Nice to meet you, Candy.
like a penis?
I suppose, yeah. You could say that.
Going right to the point. Candy. Kill her? No, it doesn't make sense. I just need to ride up to the city. I'm trying to keep as little information to this person as possible. I don't want people knowing that I went to jail. I don't want people to know my name, that know that I went to jail. I want to be kept passive and timid as possible. And now because of this interaction with Candy Moist, I don't want to see her much beyond this, as long as that information stays separated. I don't want to have her meet Candy and someone that I am trying to gain trust with at the same time, because then that's going to be a conflict of information that I am dispersing. So Candy Moist is not going to know much about me, just a little bit of like a trip to the prison, going up to Polito, going to the sheriff's department, that's it. We see each other down the road, we're still known as Dick, and if she wants...
So I'm like, what kind of stuff are you into? What do you do for fun?
What do I do for fun? Mostly a little bit of fishing, relaxing. Usually like to get out in the outdoors. How about yourself, miss? What do you do?
I like to do, like extreme stuff. I like to do, like, parkour, and I like to go, like, off-roading and stuff.
Parkour and off-roading? Oh, my. That can be very dangerous. It doesn't seem like you're wearing the proper attire for such an activity.
Well, I wouldn't want to cover up any of this.
Okay, fair enough. What exactly does the... I've read about it, but I haven't really... don't know much beyond that. What's that parkour thing about exactly?
Climb on stuff and you get to... I try to get to places where I feel like nobody's ever been before.
Ah, okay. So, basically just going on a hike. Really is all that is. I do that stuff all the time.
It's like, urban hiking.
Urban hiking? I don't follow.
Like going over buildings and stuff instead of like going over rocks and stuff.
Going over buildings, Deegan. Oh, that sounds illegal. Is that legal?
I guess it all depends on where you go.
Interesting. Okay, well, thank you for enlightening me on the activities of parkour.
Is Baby Yoshi on? Yep. Is Timmy on? Yep. Got it. Dick Hooks enjoys motorboating. God damn it. Did someone say Richard? Please get Timmy and Katie in the woods. We can go for a nature walk, maybe. Maybe I'll do something like that. That could be something we could do. But I don't want to get too involved with Tim, like Tim Mack's character. I want to keep him at a distance, but maybe like an information piece. I don't know.
Well, here you are.
Ah, thank you. Oh, just one second here. Oh, I was told that my truck was going to be here. Interesting. I don't see a truck. Give me 1 minute. Mm-hmm. No garage. Shit. Bucky didn't leave. Well, unless it was a despawn, I don't know. Work tomorrow? No, I don't work tomorrow. Shit. Oh, darn it. Well, I don't think my vehicle is here. I'm sorry to bother you again, ma'am. You don't mind giving me a ride down to the city, do you? I could pay you dearly. How much? I didn't even bother asking. My apologies. I didn't even ask you how much it cost for the first trip here.
I mean, you could really just give me whatever kind of... I don't really charge a fare. If you want to give me a tip, I would gladly take a tip from you.
How does $600 sound?
I mean, that's a good size tip.
Perfect. Thank you so much again for this. Means a lot.
That's not a problem at all. I was going to be heading back down to the city anyway.
Oh, wonderful. You've lived here most of your life?
Yeah, I grew up in Sandy Shores, and then I moved to Los Santos when I was old enough to move out on my own. And I got a job over at the Vanilla Unicorn.
Oh, you're working the, I know the Vanilla Unicorn. I can't say that I am a frequenter or anything, but I know what happens in there. Sorry, you got me flustered here. Do you enjoy working there?
Yes, I do, absolutely. I love the attention.
What type of people usually visit your establishment?
All sorts of different kinds of people. Some nicer than others.
Okay. Tell me, just a shot in the dark here, just out of curiosity. Do you know a bunch of younger hooligans? They dress pretty colorful, particularly ones named Danny, Grant, Daquan, and Jesse.
Ugh. Well, Danny. Fucking Danny. That sounds... Danny Slater. Sounds like a fucking piece of shit.
Piece of shit? Oh, dear. What did he ever do?
He stole my Jeep and he put it into a pond. And then when I went and I beat him up for it, then he told the cops on me and I went to jail.
Oh, my. Oh, dear me. Well, I can't say that I've met that Danny, but I did meet a very rude one. I took him on a nature excursion a while ago. And he was very rude and cursed too much. And very, very disrespectful. Same goes with that friend of his,
What's his name? Ah, Grant. You know Grant?
I know that my friend Sophie used to date him, and then he dumped her over the phone, like over text, like a big jerk.
Oh, dear. Well, that's not very nice now, is it?
No, I mean, you could at least do it to her face.
Tell me, what do you know exactly about Grant? I don't know him really too well. I wanted to actually talk to him a bit about the nature excursion we went on. I feel kind of bad a little bit. I want to give him a refund.
Time to go.
Time to go?
I don't really know him too.
Yeah? We're going yeah, now?
They kind of just keep to themselves.
Like, the first time.
Huh?
Check and find out what's going on.
But... yeah, it's all systems down. Okay.
It's...
all right, I got
Sophie
one.
Sophie might
baby
know
time.
A little bit more about him. She did.
Ma'am,
him.
Could you pull over quickly?
Unfortunately, this is the end of our adventure. My apologies. I do have to go. It's a bit of an emergency. I had a very important text. It was lovely meeting you, but have a wonderful day.
You as well.
Gabba yabba! All right, we're done! We gotta go!
And he already recognizes the face.
Shit! Hold on. Oh, God. I'm delaying. I'm delaying. One second. Hold on. All right, Go here. Go there. All right, bye, everybody. I'll talk to you later. Wish me luck. Take care.